cruciferae family. Now it provides us food. So mustard, cabbage, turnip, radish, these are all members of food providing cruciferae family. Oil yielding plants are the rye and mustard, basically the black mustard, which is called as Brassica nigrum. Medicinal plants, Lobularia, provide us the medicine against gonorrhea disease. It's a sexually transmitted disease. And in the same manner, Iberis amara, is its English name is candytuft, nice perfume giving flower. And this plant provides us medicine against gouts and rheumatoidism. Then remember, candytuft is also ornamental plant. There are many varieties of Iberis now. White is the normal one. Otherwise, different shades of purple and maroon colors are there. So these are the ornamental plants. Now, Malvaceae family. Food is provided by ladyfinger. Abelmoschus esculentus is a scientific name of ladyfinger or okra. Fibers come from cotton. Cotton is gossypium. Then edible oil also come from cotton. Ornamental plants include China rose and hollyhock. And medicinal plants include the Urina lobata, which its bark is used against hydrophobia. So these are the importance of these families. Now this brings us to the next topic, and that is the floral diagram. Now how do you draw the floral diagram, and why do you need the floral diagram? First thing is, the floral formula does not give you every information clearly. For example, it does not tell you the estivation, it does not tell you the placentation. So when we draw the floral formula, it helps us to understand the placentation, as well as which side is interior side, which side is posterior side, because mother axis is always mentioned in the case of the floral diagram. So let's quickly go through this also. We have already covered that Fabaceae family is bracteate, so you can see there's a bract drawn here. Let's first of all see from here. Fabaceae family members are bracteate, zygomorphic, bisexual. So you can see in this diagram, bract is shown here. Now this flower cannot be cut into equal halves by these planes. The radial symmetry is not possible. The only symmetry possible is zygomorphic. Now the next characteristic is bisexual. So you can see here, female portion is also there and male portions are also there. So both things are there. Now calyx are 5 in number and they are fused. So you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 calyxes are drawn and they are touching each other. This touching means they are fused in nature. Then if you see the corolla, 1 is standard, 2 are wings and 2 are fused, and these are the carina. So let's see this one. The largest one is the standard, the posterior. This end, this is mother axis, always showing the posterior side of the flower. So this side is the posterior side. So this is the largest petal, and then these two are the lateral one, and then you can see these two are fused here. Now you can see the estivation also, vexillary estivation. We have already covered in the syllabus before. One is exterior. These are the side one, and this is the anterior one. So posterior, lateral, anterior. Now check out the andrecium. Andrecium are 9 fused with their filaments and 1 would be alone. So you can see in this diagram, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 stamens have been shown. Anthers are free and a line is passing through, which shows their filaments are fused, and 1 is separate. So 9 plus 1 arrangement. And then the gynecium. Gynecium shows you 1 carpel. But in this diagram, you can easily see marginal placentation. So this is the good thing about floral diagram, because it gives you the placentation also. So only 1 ovule is visible in the marginal placentation when you cut a section, a cross section. When you make a longitudinal section, large number of them are visible. I have already covered these things in the previous lecture. Now this brings us to the Solanaceae family. So let's quickly see first of all. Bract could be present or absent. Actinomorphic flower, bisexual, 5 fused, 5 fused, epipetalous, 5. So let's quickly see. I have not drawn a bract here because it may be absent, posterior most surface. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 calyxes are there and 5 sepals are there and they are fused. You can see in the diagram. In the same manner, the corolla or petals are also fused. You can see a line drawn in between which shows they are attached. Then you can see one more thing. Both sex organs are there, so it is bisexual. It can be cut into two equal half by the radial symmetry, so actinomorphic flower. And then you can see there are 5 stamens and they are epipetalous. You can see they are attached to the petals. Then gynoecium carries 2 carpels and fused. So you can see it's fused. 2 carpels and 2 locules are there. See here it is only 1 locule. Here we have 2 locules. And then this diagram even tells us that it is exile placentation. You can see a swollen placenta and large number of ovules are arranged around it. Now Liliaceae family. Liliaceae family is bracteate, actinomorphic, bisexual, perianth 3 plus 3, endrysium 3 plus 3 and fused, gynoecium 3 fused. Let's quickly go through it. So Liliaceae family similarly will have a bract here, bisexual, both portions are there, actinomorphic can be cut into equal parts through the radial symmetry. Then 3 tepals are outside and 3 towards the, it's something like this, 1, 2, 3 and then 1, 2, 3. So 3 plus 3, similarly petals, stamens also 3 plus 3 and carpels also 3. And exile placentation is visible. So with the help of the floral diagram, things which are not clear in the floral formula becomes clear with the help of the floral diagram. Similarly, in the crucifera, you can see parietal placentation, 2 plus 2 calyx, bract is absent, actinomorphic flower, bisexual, corolla will be 4 in number. And then endrysium are 2 plus 4, and gynoecium again same way clear. And in this one also Malvaceae family, it's clear, just like in the case of the floral formula, all portions are present in the case of the Malvaceae family.